All right, so we are on the play here, because we have bounce lands in our deck. And gonna keep this hand. The old Aura Touch Mage, which our deck is entirely built around, has made an appearance here. Got Mardu online. You just play this first. I have nothing to ping other than my opponent. Hopefully, the Spark Mage Apprentice can be better than that. Our opponent's Selesnya, Golgari. I don't know. They're just cycling. We've all walled up. All right. I still don't really want to play the Apprentice. It just doesn't do much on the board. The first Aura Touch Mage should get the discard 2 spell. And then I can set up a Flicker Form later. Could even get this to be ten, like play it on 10 mana. So it's getting killed in response, which means we just get to put a card in our hand. Probably should be Galvanic Arc, I think. Because that can combo with Spark Mage Apprentice. So, Aura Touch Mage is weird. If you kill it on the stack, you search your library for an aura and put that into your hand. Kind of a card you don't want to actually kill on the stack very often. I've found. From the other position, I've been on the receiving end of such shenanigans. My opponent just got a face fetters, which is clearly pretty backbreaking. So I'm probably just gonna kill that. Put a Galvanic Arc on my Spark Mage Apprentice. So can I do it all? I can play this, and then I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, so I can do that. So first tap these. Then play this. Deal that one. Right, so how much mana do I have right now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 mana. Opponent's ready to do that again. Kind of want to wait till I have one more mana to play the mage, but maybe that's bad. If I just play it here and I get Strands of Undeath, that's fine. Galvanic Arc doesn't really do anything. If I get Flicker Form, my opponent untaps and just kills my creature, that's bad. But how many ways do they have to really kill it? Can't really think of that many. Disembowel costs 7. If they play land, disembowel. I guess that's pretty reasonable. I'm not really in a rush, so. I think waiting one more turn is fine. Like one more mana. I could also be Strands of Undeath here, which would be kind of bad. All right, but I drew this, so. Play it. I'm gonna get Flicker Form and not use it. Because I can just beat her. If I do it right now, my opponent can just untap and kill my Aura Touched Mage. Whereas if I wait till the next turn cycle, I can use it on my turn and hold up 4 mana, get Strands of Undeath, and just grind my opponent out of cards, and then get Galvanic Arc. In fact, I want to upkeep it so I don't draw the Strands, I think. No, I could still draw the Strands. But I could just play Strands on it if I draw Strands, which is fine. So yeah. Kind of got the hard lock, almost. Our opponent has to have two removal spells, one of which operates at instant speed in response, which is pretty rare. So we've got a Moldervine Cloak. Can almost set up a hex too. Could just take 7 this turn. I guess I only take 6, actually. Except I could prevent 1. Kind of don't want to jump with this because of Hex. So opponent does that pre-combat. Well, now I just get to block and flicker. Because my opponent tapped out of black mana. So that actually is going to be just fine. Unless, of course, they go... If they play a land, and then have Last Gasp here. But. So now I get Strands of Undeath. Discard 2 cards. The game's basically over at this point. Our opponent has multiple Moldervine Cloaks. What a great deck. Tap one too many by accident. Tap 4 lands for no good reason. It's gonna be okay though. Alright, so our opponent discards 2 cards. Brainspoil Siege Worm. Yeah, Brainspoil doesn't answer this. Galvanic Arc. And I guess just shoot down a Sapperling here. Actually, I'd probably shoot my opponent's face. Because of Hex. Now I can block and regenerate, and I don't even have to flicker. Moldervine Cloak doesn't do a lot here, actually. So this can block and prevent to itself. So this blocks here, this blocks here. This prevents to itself, this flickers. Then come back. Deal 3, discard 2. And I guess flicker. I can always just regenerate if my opponent hasn't played out their card yet. I also need to set a main phase hold on my opponent's second main phase because of flicker form, so I go land, lurking informant. Flicker. It comes back. This is a pretty sweet way to win a game. Opponent's on a pretty fast clock. Six a turn. Alright. Well, nice engine. So I could play either of these. I mean, this is pretty good against our opponent going big with Bramble Elementals and Moldervine Cloaks. Sewer Drag is good again. I don't actually think this card's that great, although it does combo with Galvanic Arc pretty nicely. So does Dark Blast with Galvanic Arc. Maybe I want to keep both. Actually, I could just cut this again. That's what I did last time. That worked out well. When our opponent has 4/4s. So I think I'll just make that one change and submit. The Ancestors are really good versus just a straight 4/4. Bad versus Moldervine Cloak, but it's okay versus Moldervine Cloak on a 1/1. Lurking Informant, not at the best versus Moldervine Cloak, because I can't actually prevent my opponent from drawing it. Alright, so we're on the draw here. I didn't pause recording quite as quickly as I would have normally in between game 1 and game 2 there, just because I'm used to streaming where we have to sit there and wait for the opponent to show up. So apologize for that, I'll be better about that next time. Anyways, this hand's quite good. If I just draw a swamp, which, hey, we did. It's pretty nice. I only have flicker form left to get if I draw our creature, but I think I'll just Dark Blast that and play a Sneakweed here. Before our opponent plays anything else or is able to pump that up. Opponent just dredges it. I can just dredge my Dark Blast. Around and around we go. Unless our opponent's plan could be Sfog Thos. Pretty happy to just get the Dark Blast back though. Hex, Mind Moil, Mausoleum Turnkey. Well, those cards are good. I'm just going to put strands on my guy. I think I still just Dark Blast it now. If my opponent goes Moldervine Cloak and then something to keep it alive. Yeah, I'm just fine to kill it right now. Well, I have my creatures stranded. My opponent only showed Brain Spill as a way to kill it, though, and Last Gasp. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna Dark Blast. Again, a lot of these decisions are sort of more instinct-based. I don't know exactly what I'm playing around in these older formats, so it's a little trickier. You get smaller sample sizes, and then... Okay, so my opponent's just trying to fill up the graveyard with Sfog Thos and chain all the dredge. That's what I think's going on, but... I have Galvanic Arc, and I have Strands of Undeath, so... I'm just gonna draw, I guess. I have... Galvanic Arc kind of does just the same thing. My opponent dredges and then plays a land. It's fog those me. I'm fine with that. A 3/3. Now that they have that, I can. Okay, they didn't even attack. Huh. That's weird. Don't really want a Dark Blast. Oh, that card's very good. So I'll just keep attacking. Also, if I draw Flicker Form ever, I could just put it on the Stinkweed Imp. Alright, that makes sense. But I could just get Stinkweed back next turn. And put Galvanic Arc back on it. One, two, three. This is only a 3/3 still. Our opponent only had one last gasp last game. Could have multiples. I guess they had the recollect, but they just milled that. Probably don't have multiples of that card. To note, there's 13 lands between our opponent's graveyard and play, so... Opponent's doing this, so next turn they can dredge the other Shambling Shell and just play two of them in a turn. So I could draw for a turn, or just play Stinkweed Imp this turn. I think drawing this turn is good. Because I don't actually have anything to kill with the Arc yet. And I think my opponent's very likely to get Shambling Shell back. So now even fewer lands on top. So let's get back Sneakweed Imp. Attack with the Night Guard Patrol. My opponent can block and sack and put on the second Shambling Shell. But if they do that, I get to then play my two cards. Do I kill a Shambling Shell or just dome my opponent in the face for three? They can always just sack this in response anyway, or sack this later when they want to. I think. I think I'm just gonna hit my opponent for three. Although, I have the benefit of forcing the Shambling Shell to sack onto itself. Maybe that's better. The 3 damage is relevant, but not that relevant. I guess getting a Sphogthos bigger is a little bit annoying. Though it's not that annoying. As long as I have my Stinkweed Imp, I feel like I'm going to win. How am I winning this game? I could deck my opponent with Lurking Informant. I can I can basically just keep my opponent from ever finding a removal spell, and then Stinky Imp wins. So, if that's the case, I should just kill a shell. This is gonna just... Yeah, this is good. Our opponent gets back the shell, which is actually good for us. Again, Stinkweed just blocks everything. First strike, death touch, essentially. Pretty broken combination. Don't need a dark blast. So just informant you. Bramba Elemental. I feel like my opponent can just have that. Well, now I have to keep any Fists of Ironwood from coming down. That's a good one. Opponent's kind of getting locked out. Every time I put on top, my opponent could get tricky and then sacrifice one of these to dredge it away, but then they just have a shambling shell, so it doesn't really do that much. I don't really understand this attack. My opponent doesn't know what Stinkweed Imp plus First Strike does. We know our opponent drew Farseek this turn. We just literally can't have anything. Farseek. Or touch mage, which doesn't actually do that much right now. I'd rather use the informant. I can do both once I draw more land. Then I can get flicker form just to block. Overwhelm. No, you can have that. It doesn't do anything. Doesn't give trample. And our opponent can't activate Sphagnos and use it, so we're not even going to get hit for that much damage. Just 7 mana plus 3 plus 3. Devouring Light is nice. Vigor Mortis. Return something and get a counter on it. Transilluminate. Primal Wood Fists. This just returns a siege worm and puts counter on it, and then I can just Devouring Light it. My opponent can have that too. None of these actually deal with my board. The main thing I'm afraid of is just a last gasp. So, binning the Vigor Mortis and then letting my opponent draw a removal spell is pretty bad, I think. Get back Bramble Elemental, sure. I could have sacked this to get rid of this in response, but this is clocking my opponent pretty hard, so I think it's not worth doing. Carbon Caryatid. Draws an extra card for free, so I might as well... Well, I guess actually my opponent can have that, because it requires mana. It can tap for Overwhelm, though, so I wonder if that's a consideration. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. My opponent can just have it. It's fine. I'm going to have to draw, like, exactly Carbon Caryatid into a last gasp here to get out of it. And even if that happens, I have Devouring Light. Also, can't Moldermine Cloak this turn, which is pretty nice. And I have Lethal with Stinkweed plus Sewer Drag on board. So, it's probably game. I think I'm gonna go for it. My opponent needs an instant way to, and they would have just cast that already, I think. Okay. So, match 3 coming up.